In this lesson, we're going to look at how to add text on top of your image in a way that looks really professional. And for this lesson, we're going to look at Spark Post. So I tap on Spark Post, made by Adobe, and they have made this app to help us make really eye-catching, professional-looking posts. Now, if you want to create a post from scratch using your image, you're going to come over here and you're going to tap on the plus, and then do you want to use a free image or do you want to use an image from your gallery, from your phone or your tablet's device? I'm going to tap on gallery and this has all the images on my device. So I'm going to pretend that we have a restaurant and we are sending out a social media post about Valentine's Day. So I'm going to select my image there. I'm going to tap on add one. And the next stage then is it asks me what do I want to use the image for, and I can crop it to all different sizes. I have a separate video lesson on how to use Spark Post for cropping. I'm just going to go with square because I'm going to use this on Instagram and Facebook. I can move the rows a little bit around in there and I'm happy with that as a crop. So I'm going to tap on done. So firstly, you open Spark Post, you select your image, you crop it to the size that you would want. And now we're going to look at how to add the text. So you double tap to edit the text. So I double tap and then I'm just going to tap on the X there to get rid of that text. And I'm going to type book now for Valentine's Day. So I want this text on top of my image and I want it to look really good. So I tap on the tick top right. Now that doesn't look fantastic. And if you're using this on your own, you might then be tempted to play with the color and the font and the shape. But my advice is come down here and tap on done. And then you would tap on design. And that really is where this app comes into its own. So if I tap on design, it'll now show me lots of layouts for my text and layouts that makes the text look really professional. So if I tap on this one here, it'll pop the text up there and I can just pinch in on it to make it a bit smaller and I can position it there. And if I scroll over here and I tap on this one with the balloon, my text pops down there and then I can pinch in, make it smaller, and I could just kind of put it there. And let's say here, I can put that up there. Book now for Valentine's Day. I'm sure you're getting the idea how this is working. Pinch in and I could put that up there as well. So there's lots of lovely different layouts that you can have your text appearing in. So really, really nice. I'm going to go back and I'm going to, I think I'll select that one there. So I'm just going to pop my image, my text up there, maybe make it a little bit smaller and pop that there. Now, next thing is there is the Spark Post watermark there. I don't want that on it, and it doesn't cost any money to remove it. You just tap on that watermark, and it does say that if you want to replace their watermark with your logo, you could upgrade to the professional. I think the professional plan is like 10 euro a month or something. You don't need to do that. I'm just showing you how to use it for free here. To remove the watermark, all you got to do is tap on remove logo on this project. And now it's gone. Then when I'm happy with it, I just tap on done. And I'm going to come up here to tap on download. It says preparing your post. And now that image has been saved to my desktop. So lots of different ways that you can use, or lots of different fonts and styles that you can use there for Spark Post. Before I finish, let me just show you one thing. Let's say I was happy with the text. I'm happy with this container for the text, but I don't really like the font. I'm just going to tap on the font there. And when I tap on the font, I can then select font and I can browse through the different types of fonts. So do play around with that because they have lots of lovely fonts. And you can just get it the way you want. Also, if I tap on it again, maybe I don't like the red background, so I can tap on color, and then I can work my way through the different colors here. Get the idea? I'm tapping on them twice because it then reverses the color. So there's lots of different ways you could have that. Maybe I wanted more silver. So I'm going to tap down, and then I'm going to move my text up there, and I could actually pinch in and make it a little bit bigger. Or I could move it up there. Just give it a lot more room. Let's say I'm happy. I'm going to tap on done in the bottom right. Then I'm going to tap on the download arrow. And now it's saving the post. So that's Spark Post, and it's brilliant for adding professional looking text onto your images.